Hello again, everyone. Today we're going to install a GDEMU unit into a PAL Sega Dreamcast. This is a GDEMU unit here. It was manufactured on the 9th of September 2014. It's board version 5.4, which it says here. So this is the unit. On the reverse side, you see the IDE interface, which is going to plug into where the GD ROM unit currently plugs into. This is going to plug in instead. A couple of standoffs here. You also get a screw with a standoff as well, which goes, you can see that screw with its standoff, and that goes through here and it just supports the unit when it's installed. So first of all, what we want to do is disassemble the Dreamcast. We've got a couple of screwdrivers to do this. We're going to use a bigger one. First things first, you turn your Dreamcast upside down like so. You need to look here as well and make sure it says 1 for the version of your Dreamcast. Mine says 1 PAL E, so it's the right version. So first things first, take out the modem or LAN adapter or broadband adapter, depending on which one you have. It can be quite tricky to get out. There we go. You need a bit of force, push down, and out it comes. That reveals a screw here. There's also screws in each of the other corners, here, 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 and here. So we're going to quickly remove them. Right, so with all four screws removed, put them somewhere safe, turn your Dreamcast back the correct way, and the lid will just lift straight off like so. Nothing holding it in place. Here is the GD ROM unit. It's secured by three screws. There's a screw here, and then two on the reverse side at the front here. There's one down there, which, you can see it there. So one there, and one there. So I'm going to remove those screws. Right, with those three screws removed, we want to lift up the GD ROM unit. It's secured around about here with a clip that's clipping it in the IDE connector. So you don't want to rock it left and right or up and down. You want to lift straight up, but it's got quite a secure connection, so you need quite a bit of pressure. So grip it everywhere you can and lift up, and it just unclipped then. So lift it free of the unit. There's the clip that it came from, and there's its connector on the bottom. So we're just going to move that out of the way and put it somewhere safe. And we're ready to install our GDMU unit. Line up the GDMU over the slot. Force like that. Next, what we want to do is slide this sleeve from the screw under the board. Slide the sleeve from the screw under the board here, and then feed the screw through. So that's what we're going to do now. Then what you want to do is feed this screw that you got through the board and through the standoff. Make sure it goes through the standoff, because that's the whole point of it. And then screw this in gently. Very, very stiff screw. And there we go. So that holds it against the board nice and tight. It's not going to move. It's nice and secure. I think you could do one more screw turn actually on it. There we go. Yeah, so the firm, if you see what I was doing there, I'm not sure you can look, put it this way. There's no rocking, there's no movement. It's a nice, solid, secure connection. So that's the GD ROM unit installed. Next, what you want to do is get your lid and place it back over the top like this. Flip the unit upside down, and we want to return our 4K screws. So let's do that now. Drop them down all the holes, and then you can just go around with one screwdriver and pop them all back in. So let's screw them back in. Last step, you want to get your LAN adapter of modem and reconnect that. Flip the unit the right way around. And that's the GD-ROM unit installed, GDMU, as you can see inside. So, I'll set it all up and I'll come back to you and I'll show you how to set up the software on the SD card and how to run some games with it. So, back in a second. Right, so now we need to get the firmware for the GDMU. If you go to gdmu.wordpress.com and click the updating firmware button here, tab here, and let it open up, and it gives you instructions of what to do. We extract the firmware to an SD card, we rename it gdmu.firmware, we put it in the Dreamcast, and then we power it on. The LED will blink, and then it'll go into a pattern where it blinks for half a second on, half a second off, repeatedly. When it gets to that stage, we power off the Dreamcast, remove the card, and remove the update file. So that's what we're going to do. We need to download the update, but There's an issue with the latest update, this one, 5.8.1. It removes the limit of 40 games per SD card, up to 999 images, but it breaks support with GDMenu, which is a piece of software we want to use to select games. So we're going to use the older firmware here, 5.7.0, until that issue is fixed. So let's download this update file. So we're downloading from Senspace. Click here to download from Senspace. GD menu option. So click save file here. It saved it dead quick. We're going to open it. Let's drag up WinRAR here. We're going to extract it to our SD card here. And it's extracted there. So go back to the page and we'll go back to the instructions and we'll just copy and paste the name it wants, GDEMU.firmware. So we'll just copy that. Jump into our SD card folder here. That's not our SD card folder. It's our SD card folder. So we're going to rename it GDEMU.firmware, like such. So that's the SD card set up to update the firmware of the Dreamcast, which is what we're going to do now. So if you go into your taskbar and go to your safely remove hardware, right click it, give it a second. And we want to reject my storage device, which is the SD card. So we click that. It's now safe to remove. It removed it automatically. And we'll go update our Dreamcast. So back in a second. Right, so now we've got our SD card with our firmware update file on it. So we're just going to open the Dreamcast and insert the SD card into the SD card slot like that. Oh, wait a second. We've got to lock the SD card. So I'll just lock that like so. Place it into the unit. It's a bit tricky to line up and get in. There we go. And then secure. Power the unit. You see the LED flashing for a second. And now it's pulsing on the half a second on and off. But we'll just be certain, so we'll just give it a couple of extra seconds. But yeah, that looks like it's flashed. It was only 64 kilobytes. So it says at this stage, we power off the unit and remove the SD card. So that is what we're going to do. So power it off and remove our SD card. Right, so next up, we'll get some games going. So let's go back to the PC. Right, so now we need to set up our SD card with some games. To do this, we're going to use GD menu. The latest version is 0.3. I've got the link here. If you see on the GDMU site and you go to the links, you see it has a link to GD menu, but it has it to the 0.2 version, which is out of date. So I'll put a link in the description to the latest version, which we're going to get now. So let's go download this. Come on, browser. Just go. So download GD menu. Save file. Okay. Let's open that up, and we'll have a read of the readme. So instructions. We require firmware 5.7.0, which we got. That's the instructions for installing the firmware, which we've done that. So if the folder 01 already exists on the SD card and isn't empty, move the disk image inside to another folder. Well, we don't have the 01 image, but we've got it in the GD menu download, so we'll just extract that straight to the root of the SD card. So that's done, and the INI file we'll put on the root. Let's go back to the instructions. Insert the SD card in your Dreamcast and power on. Upon boot, it'll show you the game list. Right, so we need to put the games on. So let's close that, and come back to our folders. Right, so now we need to copy our games over to the SD card. To do this, they all need to be named in numbered folders. So like here we've got 01, which is GD menu. 02 is going to be Jet Set Radio. 03 Marvel vs. Capcom and so on. So basically you just rename the folder like so, 02. Inside the folder you have your GDI file like this. This is equivalent to a CDI file as well. So we need to rename this to disk.gdi. And if you're not using TOSEC raw GD ROM images like I'm doing here, if you're using like a scene release or something you've downloaded with a CDI extension, you have to rename that as well to disk.cdi and have it in a folder like 02, 03 and so on. So I'm going to do this for them all.
Let's do this one again. O3, inside, rename the GDI file to disk.gdi. So I'm going to do that for them all and then come back to you. Right, so I'm on the last one here, so I'll just show you one last time. So this folder's called 19. We'll go inside it and we rename the GDI to disk.gdi. Like so. So that's all my folders renamed. Inside every folder, the GDI has been renamed to disk.gdi so the GDMU can read it. So all we've got to do now is copy our games over to our SD card. So right-click, copy, right-click, paste. And this is going to take a while. It's a Class 10 SD card, but it's 20 gigabytes of games almost. Yeah, 20.1 gigabyte. So it'll take about 20 minutes or so. So I'll come back to you when this process is finishing. So back in a minute. Right, so it's just about finished copying over now. 5 seconds to go. So all our games are now on our SD card with our INI file. All the GDIs are named disk.gdi. So the next step, we right-click here and safely eject the SD card. That's done. And we'll go test it on our Dreamcast now. So join us in a second.
Right, so here's my SD card with all my games on it. I'm going to pop this into my GDMU unit. Like so. Make sure it's in firm. Power on my Dreamcast. You can close the lid then. Right, let's test this out. Right, set the date. I still haven't fixed my battery, so it's going to keep on asking for that. If we just click play, it should load up GDMenu. Here we go, so we're loading up. And here we go, so it found O1, which was GDMenu. Then it lists the games, so Jet Set Radio, Marvel vs. Capcom. You can see it lists the region, if the game supports VGA mode or not, how many discs there are, the date of the release, well, the date the disc was mastered, and the disc version. So let's try out a game. We'll give Resident Evil a shot. You'll also notice that it's got, some games have got images, some don't. That's if they have the image file on the disc, the PTR file. If they have that, then GDMenu will display it. If they don't have that, it won't display it. So you can see all the different ones for Shenmue there. So we'll give Resident Evil a shot. I like Resident Evil, and it's got a nice cutscene at the start that we can test it out with. Bomb bomb. Checking visual memory. This game contains explicit scenes of violence and gore. IDOS Interactive. Capcom. Right, see, it looks like it's booted. If we don't press anything, it should start playing the opening movie, which is what we want to see. Giving it a second. There we go, so it's going to start playing the opening movie now, isn't it? Oh no, it's going to show a demo. Right, there's no actual way of getting out of the menu with, you can do a soft reset with the Dreamcast, but you're not going to, oh, you can get to that. But if you press play again, it's going to start loading Resident Evil Code Veronica again. So the only way to get out of this is we have to power cycle to get back to the GD menu. So we'll do that now, and we'll just try out another game. Just while it's loaded up, I thought I'd show you that I do in fact do own all these games that I said I did. Which way? That way. So that's one pile. That's the other pile. A lot of them are still factory sealed, so yeah, not pirating anything. We're using them to back up and save the life of our GD ROM unit, because a lot of them are starting to burn out by now. Right, so GD menu's loaded up again. So we will try Shenmue, which is a fan favourite. So Shenmue 1 actually. Will we ever see Shenmue 3? That is the question. So the load times are a lot quicker as well. We can play it at 60Hz. When you're playing safe, this play data at 60Hz mode, you'll only be able to play it on a 60Hz PAL monitor from now on, that's fine. So GDEMU, I should load up the passport disk, but work on a new game, we can see the opening movie. This takes up a massive amount of memory card space to GDEMU, 80 blocks on GDEMU 1, which is a lot because the memory cards only hold 200 blocks. The file has been created. So we'll let this open movie play through. Right, so a few things to know about GDEMU before we go. You can order them from gdemu.wordpress.com, the site we were visiting earlier. It takes about 4 weeks for your order to get shipped to you because he's making them on the fly. And yeah, check the description for the GDMenu link for the latest version. And that's about it. I hope you enjoyed this mod. We'll let this video play through and then that'll be the end of it.
Ryo-san,
just show you off in the Dreamcast. No disc inside at all.
My father. Fuku-san!
Ryo-san!
Fuku-san!
Landy. We will defeat you one day, Landy, if we ever get GDEMU 3. An evil dude.
Father!
Stay back, Ryo.
For the last time,
where is the mirror?
I've no intention of telling you.
Father, why?
Now then,
no matter how often you ask, I'll never tell.
No, don't!
Hand over the mirror. Or else, your son.
Wait! The mirror, it's buried under the cherry tree.
Do you remember Chao Sun Ming?
Chao?
That's the name of the man you killed in Moon Swan.
It can't be you!
Get up. I'll allow you to die like a warrior. Father. Renmi-sama, we have it.
That's where we'll leave it. What an awesome intro to a video game. What an awesome mod for a Sega Dreamcast. Please rate and subscribe if you enjoyed this video, and join us next time when we do something else cool. Bye, everybody.